It might sound a little counterintuitive, but sometimes not rhyming can actually get your point across better and in a way that hits harder than if you do rhyme. We're so conditioned to listen to rhymes that when somebody doesn't rhyme, it can make us listen to what's actually being said a little more. Two examples off the top of my head are Lupe Fiasco and On Phoneme.
I wish that you were lying. I hope that none of that comes true. Ooh. Rappers die too much. That's it, that's the verse.
And Dr. Dre in The Message.
I have been through all emotions, from in shock to keeping a poker face to straight breaking down and showing all emotions. From anxious to believing real G's don't cry. If that's the truth, then I'm realizing I ain't no gangster. It's just not me.
But to me, the most enduring example of this and the hardest hitting is actually by Eminem and his 2004 song Mosh. The song was made in the wake of 9/11 and the war in Iraq and Afghanistan, and is a reflection of Eminem's moral opposition to those wars. Which I will say is a take that has aged quite gracefully, but at the time it was a lot more controversial than it is now to speak out about it and have the same views that Eminem had. Hindsight, of course, is 20/20, but at the time it was very politically charged and a lot of people had conflicting opinions on it. So Eminem took to the song to criticize America and specifically George Bush, and one line in particular just sticks out so hard and is actually quite personal. The song is about George W. Bush, but you might not know that George Bush's father, George H.W. Bush, was also a president of the United States, and George Bush's father was the acting president during the Gulf War. This was in the early 90s and also took place in the Middle East. Nearly 90,000 tons of bombs were dropped during the Gulf War and it decimated the area. Fast forward 10 years, Bush Jr.'s in office, 9/11 happens. A couple years later, Eminem makes this song, and this is what he says.
Maybe we can reach Al-Qaeda through my speech. Let the president answer high anarchy. Strap him with an AK-47, let him go fight his own war. Let him impress daddy that way.
Eminem is obviously a rapper known for some savage lyrics, but this to me is honestly his most savage. And to insinuate that George Bush is willing to put the death of millions of people on his shoulders and have their blood on his hands just in an attempt to impress his father, that is just so personal and so savage. Because it's like, for one, you don't have the respect of your father and you're trying to earn it, and the lengths you're willing to go to achieve it, to have hundreds of thousands of innocent people die, the people of Iraq and the American military, all just to impress your daddy. This to me is one of the most savage lines I've ever heard in my life, and illustrates how not rhyming can get your point across, maybe in a better and more direct way than if you were rhyming. And I think this really proves it, because Eminem is known for his rhymes. Regardless of where you land on the topic, politically, I think we can all agree that less death is good, and nobody wants the blood of hundreds of thousands to millions of people, especially innocent people's blood on their hands. So that to me makes it one of the most brutal, savage lines in hip-hop history. The not rhyming line is not a tactic that's often used, but sometimes when it does get used, it can make your line hit even harder. Alright y'all, thank you for watching. Peace out. Appreciate you.